Welcome to the first in a series of videos on how to get massive XP every battle. I'll start with the medium tanks, and basically the series is centered around me pointing out through gameplay a couple of examples of where I do things in a specific way and where I specifically go in various maps. So stay tuned, watch, maybe you'll learn something, maybe you can throw a couple of tricks my way. I'm happy to take input anytime. Now then, for a pattern on this map, from this side, I tend to utilize the dip right here. See, I'm going up here. Here, I will have good cover. I will be able to see them as they come. And I can roll back into cover here if necessary. Now, it works best if there's actually a heavy tank down here in cover in the right flank, but without it, so we'll probably need to go back up and get some flanking shots on the people now defending that corner. And here's where the fun starts. See how far we get off. Ricochet. There's no two ways about it, it's just a match. Now, you see I keep moving here because there's artillery around and they will try and shoot me, and if you get hit by artillery on the side while you're in the path, penetration. That's why I'm just keep moving and run their way, especially because you're running across their way the angle, so they very often will have to readjust the uncaged. Here's another thing about the Patton. It is really active on move, and using overhead shooting is indeed an option. An option you wouldn't take if you meant to have that. I guess the E50 spring to mind. German series. Not great. The Patton very often finds it is more active in overhead than it is in. So then once you know we've made them pull back, we go up along the flank here and we start taking some flank shots. Patton has decent penetration to 18, which for a 10-9 is not a lot compared to 268. So you need to be a bit more aware of what you shoot. Anyway, we're done here. That open space up there with two tank destroyers on the hill, not really my cup of tea. I can see the west flank is in trouble, so one up one over. Do you see how quickly the Patton accelerates when it gets up to top speed? It's very modest top speed, by the way, but it gets there very quickly. Maybe it's because there's not so far to go, but anyway, it keeps top speed very well, it traverses very quickly, it's pretty good at keeping the speed uphill, and so it doesn't need speed to turn, which is nice. Now I'm doing something which you can normally do with a Patton, which is sniping. The accuracy for long range engagement is, well, it's inadequate, but it seems there's a gap in our line. I want to make sure that, you know, we have some kind of cover here in case some funny guy is going to try and run down. That gives you a bit of a shot over to the left side. That was never ever going to hit. But it seems, okay, if they go forward...
Penetration!
Get some good shots in this. That was a good shot. If I can just state this for the record, hitting these small things...
Enemy armor is damaged!
...burst full speed is not easy. Have great enjoyment out of every time I do it. It turns out the sniper position actually is good for covering the flank rather than this. So, we'll come up here, I'll dump the shot. Nope.
That one didn't go through!
It's bad shooting. I could have waited 4 seconds, 3 seconds. Good.
this is so far not an extremely good game, but the reason I wanted to show you this was more to show you some positioning, some maneuvering, and how to really get the most out of your tank in terms of its ability and damage or strength. The Patton strength, very much gun depression, high DPM, good maneuverability, ability to keep speed in turns. But it has no armor.
Just because you don't have armor.
Nope, nope. You there in the corner, it does not have armor. Okay? Don't count. Stack as if you're driving around in a plastic bucket with a gun. It also shows you the versatility of the pattern. If there is trouble on one flank, you move there back and forth across the map.
Enemy is hit!
Look, there's a wall. Run, I have no one.
Enemy armor is destroyed!
Metal Borsig Waffenträger,
also known as the Rommel Ball, or the RV.
So let's see what we can do with two Rommel Bombers. Okay, he is spotted. I need to be a little bit careful because the artillery, but you look, I mean, just look at the maneuverability. It's wriggling that thing backwards and forwards, shaking its rear and its tush.
Penetration!
Hammering shot. Many other tanks have not made that shot. It's a very accurate shot. Wow.
Got him!
Starting to rack up the damage. See, not all games start with you having a great game. I have these.
Target acquired! Enemy armor is damaged! Where'd they go?
And shoot straight off of that. I don't even let the circle shrink it up. That is the pattern.
My favorite tank in the game, probably. Though I like this Centurion. And when the Chieftain comes in, that will probably be my new favorite tank. I'm not sure about the Centurion Action 10 they were talking about.
It's not a real tank. Chieftain is a real tank. I also wanted that. Anyway, I'm not even running low on health here. So
target acquired.
I also aim.
Penetration.
Something I've started doing recently is this thing.
Let's find another target.
Yeah, stop.
Enemy armor is destroyed.
And you notice how I stopped the tank 2 seconds before being reloaded, so I give myself time to aim in. So that's it for this time. We will see you soon in the next video on medium tanking.